Varun Sharma, a young and enthusiastic boy from Bhopal, has made it to the civil services in his very first attempt. Being the son of an IFS officer, his dream has always been to serve the country. An engineer by profession, Varun Sharma secured 155th rank in the first attempt and shares his experience and knowledge with our expert Rajat Saxena.
What do you think about the changed pattern of IAS main exam?
The changed pattern of this mains exam now demands from a candidate that he carries a very wide exposure of things. They are asking many interlinked and they are linking the topics like conventional with current, they are linking it very nicely. So the questions are getting more analytical and the weightage of GS has increased. One has to focus on GS and the exposure levels must be really high.
When did you start the preparations for IAS main exam?
The preparation was ongoing along with the prelims exams, or the general studies was the common part. But after basically the result of the prelims exam, I started putting more effort into it.
How did you prepare the compulsory language paper?
For the compulsory language paper, my optional till 12th standard was Hindi. And I was very comfortable with Hindi and English. My medium was English, so I had no issues in both the languages.
What was your optional subject in the IAS main exam?
My optional subject for the mains examination was public administration.
Why did you choose public administration as an optional subject in the IAS main exam?
When I started preparation for the civil services examinations, I was going through the subject syllabuses of various options and I found a connect with public administration. I was able to relate to the topics easily. Paper 2, more or less, I was able to recognize the topics. People said it's a low scoring option, but I was very comfortable with it. That's why I chose it.
Do you think the educational background of the candidates has a direct relation in choosing the subject?
As far as the linkage between the educational background and optional subject is concerned, it depends from person to person. Like a doctor can take medical science, but if an engineer is not comfortable with his branch, then he can take any other option.
What strategy did you adopt for public administration?
For public administration, sir, the strategy I adopted was I knew that it was getting very analytical and very thorough. From the past 2-3 years, they were giving less marks in that also. So whatever I studied, I tried to be sound in it. Like I read one book 10 times, because that one book reading 10 times is going to help me. Not like in GS we can switch from various sources, but PubAd you have to, public administration, you have to stick to some standard books and read them very thoroughly.
Which books did you study for public administration?
I read 2 or 3 books for public administration written by Mr. Mohit Bhattacharya. Sharma and Sadana, I was also... and some generals of Indian Institute of Public Administration I tried to follow.
What strategy did you adopt for General Studies Paper 1?
General Studies Paper 1 in the mains exam, sir, it's basically the conventional part, like history and geography. So that gets covered as soon as one starts preparing for this exam. That starts covering one student. But the point is, they are including many elements of art and culture in it, and they are asking analytical questions about art and culture, like now into the temple architecture detailed. And so NCRTs are very helpful for this General Studies Paper 1. And nothing much current in this paper. This was the only paper in which current affairs was not included much.
What strategy did you adopt for history topics?
History of the World, sir, standard 10th NCRT. It's a very good book. I read it in my school days also. So I was very fascinated by all these world wars and all. So I read that again. And then one book by Mr. Ankur Sharma, I read it. World history.
What strategy did you adopt for General Studies Paper 2?
It's a very tricky paper, this General Studies Paper 2. It has international relations and governance and the elements of political science. The point is, they're asking very up-to-date and current questions, like whatever current is happening or some Supreme Court verdict which is going to affect the democracy and the institutions of India. So one has to keep in constant update with the legal, political and social changes happening in the country for this paper, so specifically.
How did you prepare the social justice topics?
Social justice topics are IGNU module for social justice is very good. They actually link the social justice problems in India from history to current. The legislations for them, so that module is very good.
What was your strategy for General Studies Paper 3?
Paper 3, economics, sir, I was always comfortable with this part because it always complemented my reasoning. They are asking very questions based on current problems and like the Eurozone crisis and all. So one has to maintain the high exposure levels for this paper also. And the science and technology part, and this is a very diverse paper. They have included disaster management in it and very small topics, but lot many topics. So reading some standard material for all those topics is very necessary.
How did you prepare the disaster management topics?
Disaster management, sir, as I told you, IGNU module for disaster management is also very good. It's basically in two or three booklets, and the recent amendments and the legislations, how disaster prone areas are in India and geographically they link, then it's a very complete module.
How did you prepare the biodiversity topics?
Biodiversity, sir, my father being an Indian Forest Service officer, so I was my exposure towards nature was always good. Biodiversity, sir, some the current material for that biodiversity also I read, but
what was your strategy for general studies paper 4?
Paper 4 in general studies, that is the ethics, integrity and aptitude part, it's basically a reflection of your inner self, so not much preparation is required. One just needs to go through the basic taxonomy, like some basic terms of that paper, like what is the spirit of service and what is perseverance, integrity and all. But when you write the answers, it has to come from within. So that paper has been included to reflect one's inner personality in that paper.
What aspects should one highlight while writing the answers in the IAS main exam? Because now the number of questions has increased and the space is limited.
Sir, the space has been limited basically to curtail the storytelling in the answers. Now one has to try to be as relevant, as near to relevance as possible. One cannot write like stories regarding that topic what has been asked. So you have to be pinpointed and basically highlight the frontline points of your answer, like whatever you are trying to say that should reach the examiner.
How does answer writing practice help in IAS main exam?
Definitely, sir, answer writing practice helps in IAS mains exam because it's a game of time management. One has to write so many words, and in that limited time, if you have practiced before, then that will be a lot easier in the original exam.
How did you manage time in each paper?
General studies paper 1, it was a shock. For the first time, I was facing a lot many 25 questions, and they have increased the word limit, decreased the weightage given to each question. So I tried to reduce the word limit somehow, like 165, 170 words, but the attempt should be increased, because if you try writing 210, 220 in all questions, then you can't attempt all.
How did you maintain a balance between the various papers of general studies?
General studies paper, one has to find his natural aptitude, like in which paper he can score more. So paper 1 was always my weak point, but paper 2 and 3 I tried to focus more on them and attempt more in those papers so that I can score more.
What was your strategy for essay paper?
Essay, sir, I wrote that essay on science and technology like many of the students did. My strategy was including as many points and linking it to as many different phenomena we can link, like science and technology, you can link it to economics, geography and polity, and the historical touch you can give, philosophy you can link it. So basically I wrote the topic in the middle and I tried linking points to it. 55-60 points I was able to cover in that.
What tips would you like to give for essay writing?
Essay writing requires a deep and thorough thinking, so always think and brainstorm for around half an hour before you start writing your essay, because once you start writing then you can't scrabble it and all, so it has to be perfect. So think 30 minutes, 40 minutes and then start writing. Prepare all your points, prepare a platform and then start building.
How important is time management for essay writing?
Essay was the part in GS general studies in this mains exam which was comfortable on time. We have to write 2500 words and we can think and we can write. So essay was not running against time like the other papers were.
On what aspects should the candidate focus while preparing for essay paper?
If a candidate is strong in general studies paper, then somehow he can link it with essay. So essay, I don't think it requires a specialized preparation. Along with the preparation of general studies, the preparation for the essay is on.
What suggestions would you like to give to the future candidates for IAS Main?
IAS Mains is a very different ball game, like from last year. The time management and writing speed and reading speed, all the three have increased proportionally. So try to attempt more and more questions, but at the same time while increasing the attempt, try to be as relevant as possible.